Hi, welcome to Harisystems. In this session today we will learn ASP.NET top interview questions and answers, C sharp, series number 15 we will see. Explain indexers in C sharp. Indexers are used for allowing the classes to be indexed like arrays. Indexers will resemble the property structure, but only difference is indexers associate accessors will take parameters. We will see the example. Like I am implementing here for an class with my collection yes with the braces of start and end. You may aware of the program, writing of the program with the class. You will see here private yes array, it's indicating object creation. And my array equal to new s, I am taking 100. The public s, this of int small s, I am indicating here. And now here get return my array string and set my array s of the value. These are the indexers writing and indication to be write in C sharp programming language to allowing the classes to be indexed like arrays. And coming to the next one is, what are the collection types can be used in C sharp programming language? Here are the collection types in C sharp: array list, stack, queue, sorted list, hash table, bit array. These are the collection types can be used to write and implementing C sharp programming language. And coming to the next one is, explain attributes in C sharp. Attributes are used to convey the info for runtime about the behavior of elements like methods, classes, enum, etc. Attributes can be used to add metadata like comments, classes, compiler, instruction, etc. These are the attributes we may use to develop in such a situation based wherever it required. We will apply for these attributes to develop in C sharp language. The next question is, list out the predefined attributes in C sharp. Here are the predefined attributes in C sharp follows here: conditional attributes, absolute attributes, attribute usage. These are the main predefined attributes in C sharp language. What is thread in C sharp? What we have to see about the thread in C sharp? Thread is an execution path of a program where thread is used to define the different or unique flow of control. If our application involves some time consuming processes, then it's better to use multi-threading, which involves multiple threads. In a program, if we want to write in multi-thread manner or multi-thread base, we can also implement threads in our application with the usage of multi-threading. Like different threads we need to declare in a web page while implementing of the application, and we can initiate independently the thread wise customization are also possible in C sharp programming. List out the states of a thread in C sharp. Here it's asking about how many states are there, what are the states of the thread states. See, unstarted state, which is an initial state. Ready state, the thread to be ready state. Not runnable state. Dead state, These are the states are available for execution of a thread in C#. Explain the methods and properties of thread clause in C#. The methods and properties are thread clause here we described here. We'll know about it. Current culture, current thread, current context, is alive, is thread pool thread, is background, priority. These are the properties of a thread class will have in C# language. What is an object? It's a very big important question. In object-oriented programming languages, not only C# as well any other programming language, all will consider the same question and same answer only. See here, later we will have a discussion about it. An object is an instance of a class. It contains real values instead of variables. For example, we'll see here. Let us create an instance of a class called employee named Khan. Employee Khan equal to new employee, the method we are calling here. Now we can access all the methods in the class employee via object Khan. As shown below, like Khan.setName of XYZ, some name you can give in any name also, you can. That Khan will set the name of the object is XYZ. The object, it's in a box where we can put into that box and we can take in a reference or we can call it to that box. That is a major advantage of object, and that's what it is successful in object-oriented programming language also. We'll see in our next question is that, what are the access modifiers in C#? Different access modifiers are public, private, protected, internal, protected internal. These are the access modifiers are available in C# ASP.NET. Public. When a method or attribute is defined as public, it can be accessed from any code in the project. For example, in the above class, employee getName method and setName method are public. In private, when a method or attribute is defined as private, it can be accessed by any code within the containing class only. For example, in the above class employee attributes, name and salary can be accessed within the class employee only. If an attribute or class is defined without access modifiers, its default access modifier will be private. Any. In protected, with the discussion about this protected, when attribute and methods are defined as protected, it can be accessed by any method in the inherited classes and any method within the same class. The protected access modifiers cannot be applied to classes and interfaces. Methods and fields in an interface can't be declared protected. Internal. If an attribute or method is defined as internal, access is restricted to classes within the current project assembly. Protected internal. If an attribute or method is defined as protected internal, access is restricted to classes within the current project assembly and types derived from the containing classes. Explain static members in C#. If an attribute value had to be same across all the instances of the same class, the static keyword is used. For example, if the minimum salary should be set for all employees in the employee class, use the following code: private static double minimum salary is 20,000. Thank you for watching this session. Subscribe, like, share, and comment any of your views. Thank you.